गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई अंश मिश्रा वेलकम यू ऑल टू अ न्यू सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश क्लास 12. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू चैप्टर 1, द थर्ड लेवल ऑफ विस्टा. आई होप दिस वीडियो वुड हेल्प यू ऑल टू अंडरस्टैंड द स्टोरी एंड गो थ्रू इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट रिलेवेंट पॉइंट्स. सो बिफोर मूविंग ऑन विद द स्टोरी, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अबाउट इट्स ऑथर. Jack Finney, the author of the story The Third Level, belonged to the nation America. His original name was Walter Braden Finney. He was born in 1911 in USA. You can go through his specialties, that is, his works were done mostly in thrillers and science fiction. There were many novels written by him, among which The Body Snatchers, Good Neighbor, etc. were also used as his popular films. The Third Level was named for Finney's short story under the title The Third Level, and it was published in the magazine of fantasy and science fiction in October 1952. Now let's see the main characters of the story. The protagonist of the story was Charlie, a 31-year-old man, Louisa, the wife of Charlie, and Sam, who was actually a psychiatrist but also a good friend of Charlie. Now, let's move on with the story. The Third Level, written by Jack Finney, is actually related with the various harsh realities of war and people who are going through the consequences of such a state of insecurity. It deals with the modern day problems and how a common man tends to escape reality by various means. In this story, a man whose name was Charlie, he got hallucinated and reached the third level of the Grand Central Station, which only had 2 levels. The story revolves around a 31-year-old man named Charlie, who experienced something very weird. One day after work, coming from the subway, he reached the third level of the Grand Central Station. He was lost himself in the Grand Central Station. He always found himself bumping into new doorways and new corridors. Every time he had a new experience, because the station was so huge that it always end up with multiple doorways moving outside. He even started believing that the Grand Central was like a huge tree, ever pushing new tunnels and new corridors like the roots under the ground. Once he got into a mile-long tunnel and came out in the lobby of a hotel. At another time, he came up into the building of an office. There were certainly only 2 levels at the Grand Central, but Charlie asserted that there were 3 levels. He talked about the same to his friends, on which one of his friends, who was a psychiatrist named Sam, said that it was nothing but daydreaming. He explained that it was only an escape from his present life due to lot of frustration which was there inside him. The modern world was full of fear, tension and worries. The third level provided him an exit from it. His other friends also agreed with the psychiatrist. They said that his stamp collecting, that is philately, was also a temporary escape. But Charlie did not agree with them. He said that his grandfather started the stamp collection, and his grandfather's day's life was very peaceful. He did not need an escape. Besides, President Roosevelt also collected stamps, And philately is meant to be a wonderful hobby by the great men. One day, Charlie got late from his office. He wanted to reach home soon. So, he went to the Grand Central to catch a train. He walked down to the first level and then walked down another flight of stairs. He thought he had reached the second level again, but he got lost. He walked down a corridor. He thought it was wrong, but he walked on downward. He walked down a short flight of stairs and thought that he had reached the second level again, but actually he had reached the third level. The third level was entirely different and old-fashioned. There were fewer ticket windows. The information booth was made of wood. Lights were open flame gas lights. There were brass spittoons on the floor. Men had beards and sideburns. Women wore old-fashioned dresses and high-button shoes. The railway engine was small with a funnel-shaped stack. Everything looked a century old. He walked to the newsboy. There he glanced at the newspaper The World, which was the most famous newspaper of that era, so that he could confirm the date and year on the newspaper. The lead story was about President Cleveland. Later Charlie found out from the library files that it was printed on June 11, 1894. Charlie wanted to go to Galesburg. He had been there in his childhood days. It was a wonderful town with tremendous stress and frame houses. In 1894, it was a heaven of peace and tranquility. People lived a carefree life. So he asked for two tickets to Galesburg. He paid the fare in modern notes, which were different from those in 1894. The clerk thought the notes were fake and Charlie was trying to cheat him. He threatened to get him arrested. Charlie immediately turned around and fled as fast as he could because he didn't know that he is going to be fooled because he is already in a different era. Next day, Charlie bought old-style notes from a coin dealer because he could not resist his excitement of going back to third level and exploring something more. He got only 200 old dollars for 300 new dollars, but he could never again find the corridor that led to the third level. Charlie's wife was worried when she heard that he had bought old-style notes. So Charlie turned to his stamp collection. One day, among his grandfather's collection of first-day covers, he discovered an envelope. The postmark showed that it had been there since July 18, 1894. He opened the envelope, but the paper inside was not blank. It was a letter from Sam, the psychiatrist friend whom Charlie had often told about Galesburg. He had already gone there. He urged Charlie to continue to look for the third level and join him in the Galesburg of 1894. It was a wonderful place. Later, Charlie learned that Sam had bought $800 worth of old currency. Charlie hoped Sam would have set up hay and feed business in Galesburg, and that was what he had always wished to do. He could not go back to his old business, certainly not in Galesburg, Illinois. The story ends at a mysterious note where Charlie is wondering that Sam is psychiatrist. So now here ends the story. What stands out in the entire story is the extent of ease with which Jack Finney was able to bring out a common man's craving for peace and security. Like any common man, Charlie was also appreciated the so-called pleasures of everyday life and the security of the familiar. He wanted to stay in the park.